Hello, I'm Stephen Thomas and I'm a podiatrist, which is a foot and ankle specialist, and I'm based in Harley Street in London. In this video, I'm going to discuss onychomycosis, which is known as fungal nails, and this is the most common nail infection. It affects about 10% of the population, so there's a good chance that you or one of your friends or your family members have suffered from this at some point. And if you are one of those unlucky people, you'll know how difficult it is to treat. So in this video, I'm going to go through the common appearances, how you generally develop it, some other conditions that you may mistake it for, and how to diagnose it. There's another video that I'll be working on where I'll go through the common treatments available. So the typical appearance of fungal nail is when the nail becomes a little bit white or yellow discoloration to it. It can also cause some thickening of the nail or nail plate. And then the nail can also become a bit soft and brittle and often a bit crumbly as well. So it depends on how early the stages are of the infection. Early infections tend to just display just like a small dots or a line or just one section of the nail, and of course more chronic infections can infect the full nail. The more severe the infection, it can be a little bit more difficult to treat. So how do you develop it? Most people that develop fungal nail usually develop it from developing tinea pedis first, which is commonly known as athlete's foot. So you get this fungal infection of the skin on the foot, and it stays there for a long time, and over time it can migrate close to the nail and eventually work its way onto the nail and infect it that way. That's where most of the infections come from. There's also a possibility of contamination as well. So if you're sharing like a nail file with somebody that has fungal nail, there may be some fungal elements on the file that when you start filing yours, you'll transfer it over to your nail. So that's a possibility as well. The most common species of fungus to infect nails is a fungus called Trichophyton rubrum, which affects about 98% of the fungal infected nails. Generally, your risk factor increases with age. So differential diagnosis. The most common differential diagnosis for a fungal nail is when you just have a thick nail. Now, nails can become thicker over time, and the most common cause of a thicker nail is trauma. And trauma can happen like a micro trauma repetitively over a long, long time. So you'll find people who are like runners and their toes bang up against the end of the shoes. You can stimulate a thicker nail over time. The other way is if you drop a big weight. So if you drop something heavy on the toe, it can cause instant trauma to the nail matrix. And then that can force the nail to become all thick and deformed sometimes. So a thicker nail will have a more cloudy appearance, more opaque appearance. So sometimes this discoloration is just because of it's a thick nail and maybe there's no fungal elements in there at all. So diagnosing the fungal nail, the only way to do this with accuracy is to take a nail clipping and send this off to a lab. And PCR test is the most accurate way of detecting this. So if it comes back positive, then you can look at different treatment options available to you, and your local podiatrist will be able to take these clippings for you. I hope you found that video useful. If you're interested in finding out about fungal nail treatments, that will be in another video that will be uploaded shortly. Once it is uploaded, I'll try and put a link at the end of this video. And again, thank you. If you like the video, click like. If you'd like to subscribe to the channel, just subscribe and keep up to date with everything. And thank you for watching.